We'll be back as soon as we get. We just have some things we have to take care of in the States, so.
So, time to face the country western music?
I'll just call the driver.
You going to tell Clint that you're in love? I will take that as a yes, and good on ya. But I'll give you a piece of advice. Suit up. I'm talking full body armor. Because Clint, he likes to aim directly at the chest. So you gotta keep moving. Serpentine, it's your only chance. Because I'll tell you something. Uncle Clint, he may be a fine shot. But his eyes, they ain't what they used to be.
Well, if you want to test that theory, Vickers, I can draw a bead on you right now.
What are you doing here? Did they find Jared?
Not yet, but if they need me, they can reach me. I thought I'd jet over and see my beautiful wife.
Oh, well, that's wonderful.
Isn't it great? The Buchanan men together at the old compound, huh?
What are you doing here, Vickers?
Getting in the way. I'll leave you alone to talk.
All right. Who's gonna pour me a welcome to London drink? What's with the luggage here? Are you going somewhere?
Well, We were.
We were, going home.
Well, if things haven't changed, why were you heading home?
I needed to see you.
There you go. Now we're on the same page. You know, after we got done talking, I said to myself, I don't want to spend one more day without seeing you.
Oh, well, we're glad that you're here. And Joey and Kevin, they've missed you like crazy.
Wait till you see Zane. He's a real Buchanan.
And we've got a lot to talk about.
Yeah, I agree with that. I mean, if Matthew is as furious as you say he is, we might want to rethink this whole thing from top to bottom. But before we do that, could we have a drink?
If you don't, I really would like to just talk to you about this while it's fresh in my mind. Do you mind?
No, not at all.
Okay.
Bo, you'll give us a minute, won't you?
Sure. Unless you want me to stay.
Thank you. I think I can handle this on my own.
Am I missing something?
Terribly sorry. Warwick's headmistress is on the line. She says it's important.
All right, just put her on speaker. Headmistress, can you hear us?
Yes, Mr. Buchanan. I'm sorry to trouble you with this, but is Matthew by any chance with you?
No. Is he missing?
I'm afraid so.
Oh, my God.
How long has he been gone? Who was he last seen with?
There's your taxi.
I told you I was gonna take the tube. I can't afford a taxi.
The tube? It's filthy and public. I have so much to teach you. Destiny, I'm going to give you something that I've never given another human being as long as I've lived. Money.
You sure?
Yes.
What do you mean your Landview days are over? It's your home.
It was, until Dorian started to play for the other team.
Dude, Dorian still loves you. She just married that sister so she could win the election.
Well, if she wants to be mayor that bad, she can do it without me.
So what are you gonna do?
I thought I'd hang around the mansion here in swinging London, baby. Pretty good accent, right?
I'll miss you.
That may be the nicest thing anyone's ever said to me in London. We make a great team, don't we?
Dorian's gonna be sorry.
And Matthew's gonna kick himself, so to speak.
I don't know about that.
I do. Just give him a little time. Now get out of here. Go.
Oh, David, thank God.
Say that again, Nora. I think I'm growing on her, Paul.
Have you talked to Matthew?
Or Destiny? Is she back from Warwick School?
Why, what's going on?
Matthew's missing.
Did he or Destiny say anything to you?
I haven't heard from him, but if I do, I'll be sure to have him contact you.
Oh.
All right, thanks.
Bon voyage, Destiny.
So where's my son?
I'm afraid I don't have much information at this point.
You discovered he was missing.
Just before I phoned you, we were in the process of tracking down another missing student.
Another missing student? You lost two kids in one day?
Relax, just take a breath, all right?
No, she's right. We entrusted our son to this woman.
And if he'd obeyed the rules...
Oh, so now this is his fault. He's in a wheelchair, for God's sake. How do you lose a kid in a wheelchair?
I assure you, we're doing everything in our power.
Oh, well, you better find him.
Or we're bringing criminal charges.
Oh, or a civil suit.
Let's concentrate on finding Matthew, all right? He couldn't have gotten very far.
Normally, I'd agree with you, Mr. Buchanan. We'd expect to find Matthew somewhere on the grounds or in a nearby town. But apparently, he has enlisted someone else to aid in this escape.
They have a system?
Oh, yeah. My mom will make a big scene, then they'll start, you know, blaming people, then they'll blame themselves. And then my mom will start crying, my dad will, you know, pat her on the shoulder. And, you know, if things get really bad, she'll slobber all over his tie and stuff. And then they'll get mad again and start making phone calls, and have a dozen people come and track me down.
That'll cost them.
Oh, they don't care. And once they do find me, they'll do whatever it takes for me to not have that surgery.
You could always call your lawyer.
Nora. Right. What are you doing here? My God, are you the one that helped him run away?
I'm serious. As soon as we land, call your attorney. Tell her what's going on. Maybe she can meet you at the hospital.
I doubt she'd be up for that.
What do you mean? She's your attorney. You pay her to do what you say.
Yeah, but last time I called her to tell her that I was dragged off to Warwick and for her to come get me, she didn't even call me back. Some sharp tail Elgato turned out to be.
You are so out of line.
Nora!
Matthew is a minor. You had no right to take him off the school premises.
Unlike you, I would never take Matthew anywhere he doesn't want to go. I had nothing to do with this. Didn't you tell them what's going on?
Tell us what you're doing here, Taya.
And fast, please. My son's out there on his own somewhere.
Yeah, he's not on his own.
Taya Delgado?
Yeah, she's my lawyer.
She's also my mother.
Taya? You think you had trouble getting your license back the last time when you slept with the plaintiff? Wait till the board gets a load of this. You're to be disbarred for life.
Oh, look who's talking. You both knowingly violated a court order.
Oh, is that why you're here? You just came riding to the rescue? Any harm comes to my son. If he goes and gets that surgery without our consent...
He doesn't need your consent.
And I wouldn't blame him if that's the reason why he left.
But...
there are two children missing.
Oh, yes, believe me. We're going to prosecute whoever helped Matthew run away.
That kid endangered Matthew's life?
Oh, he's toast.
I wouldn't be so sure, because no one messes with my daughter. Daniela was conceived when Ross and I were stranded on that island together many years ago.
Oh, that's one way to pass the time.
Does Ross have sole custody?
No, I have sole custody. Not that such details matter to Ross. I brought her here to try to keep her safe from him. It didn't work. He found her. Security saw him sneaking in and notified me. I was in the process of trying to move her to a different school when she fled, apparently. And all this time I've been freaking out that Ross took her.
And she took off with Matthew.
Yeah, which I guess is a relief. But not really, since Ross is still out there. And when he finds out that Daniela's not here anymore...
Is Ross dangerous?
He's a father being kept from his only child. What do you think?